waving right back.
Well, you sounding good. Hey, Watermelon Man, sounding good in Cali.
Well, I appreciate that, man. We ain't even looking over that way. Well, we might be looking, catching the north corner of it up there somewhere. But we ain't looking around your neck of the bridge. But that's okay. It's a Mama Nature thing, you know.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. I was just talking to old 1104 up there in Texas. I was just talking 1104 up there on 28. Boy, he was busting loose. Finally knew I had some Texas in here, so I thought I'd come down here and see if you was around. I turned it on there, and there you are talking. Hello to you, Watermelon Man, 4040 waving.
Hello, I see you waving too, 4040. I'm gonna wave right back. Yeah, we've been in and out today a little bit, not too much. Been outside doing stuff. We got some meat on the smoker out there, and the cooker. I'm cooking up some briskets to haul to East Texas to have a little family function over there this weekend, and been out there cleaning up my coolers and stuff to haul them in Mama's car. She don't like my old pickup truck coolers with dirt and cow crap on them and stuff, so I had to scrub them babies up. Got them all shiny new looking igloos, you know. To haul them grub over. And everything's good over this way, 4040. How's everybody treating you way out west? Come on.
You know, I can't complain. No one listen anyway. Whenever I complain, it falls on deaf ears, man. But no, it's all good, man. We just having fun out here. The family's doing good. I'm doing good. Today's a little overcast today, a little cool outside, so I figure I'll spend a little time in the radio room, see what's going on. Or maybe that's just an excuse. I'm not sure. I used to have a little smoker, man. I used to smoke a lot of salmon. Used to smoke a lot of salmon. I had a little cheap, then a big cheap, and then I bought this other big smoker thing. Nothing big, but one looks like kind of R2-D2. And I used to smoke a lot of salmon. I had a real good brine I got off a friend of mine, and man, it's sweet, smoky, and man, you can't eat one piece. You can't eat one piece there, Roger.
You're kind of like them tater chips they talk about sometimes. Yeah, there ain't nothing like a good smoked salmon. Oh, boy, if you can get it lit, it's really, really good. I've had smoked salmon, smoked marlin, smoked this, smoked that. You know, a lot of smoke going on out there. Smoked wild hog, smoked beef cattle, smoked tame hogs, smoked turkeys, smoked chickens. Smoke. Well, boy, that smoke is hard to find, but if you can find it, it's sure worth it. It's larrupin', as they say. I hear you, man. Yeah, we do a lot of cooking around here, especially in the warmer months there. We don't do a whole lot in the winter. We do some hogs and stuff, but yeah, we enjoy eating and living off the land, so to speak. We use the good lumber laying on the ground, or dead trees, or limbs, or whatever, to do the fire part, and then we try to eat wild game. Every now and then we'll buy some store-bought beef products there, or chicken or two. But anyway, that's another story for another time. You look at me and tell. I like to eat well, and that is another story for another time. Maybe a Whataburger. I had one about 3 hours ago. 8:40, I stopped up there in Brownwood. I had to run and get some supplies about 40 miles north, and I had me a Whataburger with some french fries and a Coca-Cola. Oh, I could have eaten too, but I didn't want to be a hog because I want to save room for supper.
I hear you. I still got to try one of them Whataburgers, man. I still got to try one of them Whataburgers. Yeah, I used to do some hog hunting out here, and I had a guy down in Gilroy, California. I'd bring him two hogs, and he would smoke one for me, and I'd give him the other hog. He would take that, he'd clean it, do everything for me, and he would smoke it for me, package it all up. All I had to do was bring him one, which was kind of a cool deal, you know? Shoot, man, saved me some work. And he had a big old smoker, and I'd drive down there, come back, and he'd have them all in the little butcher paper, and Yeah, some smoked hog, pretty good. Yeah, I had a friend, he had some property, and he had the only water, you know, like a little pond on his property. He had, like, the only water for miles around, so them 10 big and little hogs come down there, and, man, it was like shooting them in a swimming pool. They'd come from, someone would shoot down the hill, and we'd hide behind these trees, and they'd come running by in a stampede mode. And I had one friend, the only way he would hunt them is with a knife. Me, yeah, I'll shoot them. I ain't going to have no knife, you crazy? He got bit in the hand. He got bit in the hand pretty hard one time, man. Lucky he didn't lose his hand, I tell you. He got bit hard. Little thing went right through his hand and everything. But, yeah, that was some fun stuff, man. That was some fun stuff. I used to go deer hunting. In the wintertime, I'd do a little duck hunting. Had some fun with that. A lot of quail hunting and pheasant hunting. And just in the last few years, I really messed up my shoulder. I had two operations on my shoulder, and I just can't take that shot to the shoulder. So I haven't been hunting in about 4 or 5 years. Kind of bummed me out a little bit because I like hunting. I grew up hunting. My grandpa was a hunter. My dad was a hunter. Everybody was a hunter there, Roger.
Like you, like me, I was brought up in the woods hunting all my life, and I still do, not as much as I have. But my wife, I got her turned on to it about eight or nine years ago, and boy, she's turned into a regular huntress there. Boy, she's booking her a moose hunt for this fall up north there. But anyway, it's all good. Hogs is good. You remember old Kingpin around Tyler, 0356, Kingpin? I killed a big old lactating sow one time years ago, about a 297 pounds what she weighed. That's just on the hoof. Pretty good sized old mama hog, and I cleaned her up and carried her to him, and I said, "Now you cook all this up, and whatever else you want to cook." They had a big old pit. I mean, one that, you know, he put probably 200 pounds of meat on her, briskets and, you know, all lined up in a row there, whatever. But he did it, and he called all the CBs around town, and it's been several years ago, and we had a feast, man. And it was laughing. It seems like when I cook in wild hogs, they don't taste quite as good to me as if someone else had done it, you know. But I guess I'm not through with the things, and cleaned them and all that. And them old boys, I just said, leave them away, and I will get the back straps out of them. But old sow, that's where the good eating is. But anyway, I know it's a way of life, a tradition with me, and you too, sounds like. I'm sorry you can't enjoy it like you used to on account of whatever condition that shoulder's in. But I'm all for it, outdoor life there. No kidding, I think they named a book after me, Outdoor Life. Anyway, I ain't gonna tie it up much longer here. I'm gonna get out of the way there, Scott, and I'm glad you hollered at me there. And I've been fatting out in a little, so I'm gonna get back and let it roll. I'm sure business is picking up out west, sounds like. I could hear a little something in between there, so I'll just say top of the day to you around that Golden Gate Bridge, buddy, and we'll look forward to talking to you next time.
All right, Watermelon Man. Yeah, no worries. Well, I hope to see you up in Manchester. Yeah, I remember my grandpa, he had one of the big spits in the backyard. I remember a pig in the back with an apple in them and spinning them around, and I've had them cooked in the ground with burlap sack, and I've had them all kind of different ways, man. I actually grew up in a little town called Half Moon Bay. You can look at it in your map. It's a little, they got the biggest waves in the world. I'm sure you heard about Mavericks. They got some of the biggest waves to surf in the world. But, I kind of grew up in the country. I got steel rods in my legs. I got pins in me from riding bulls. Did a lot of bull riding. I grew up in the country myself. I know you. Y'all, everybody thinks, oh, 40-40 out there in San Francisco, probably wearing a tutu and out here. But no, man, I grew up on horses and shooting and hunting from my grandpa to my dad. I lived the country life for sure, man. All right, my brother, well, take care. Hey, good to hear you, and, man, I hope you make it up to Manchester 10, because I'm going to make it out there this year. Matter of fact, I'm calling today to get my room. My airplane tickets were $461, which ain't too bad. That's both ways, so I'm not complaining there. So I'll be definitely up there in Manchester, Tennessee, so I hope to put a handshake on you. All right, my brother, take care, and I will get back with you. And to old Cherokee, we said hello and be safe out there when y'all hunting. And, damn them guys trying to take our guns away. Unbelievable. But that's a whole nother story right there. Hey, Watermelon Man, take care, my friend.
Appreciate it. Here's two quick comments there before you get them out of there. That, you know, the government's buying up ammo and destroying it. I don't know if you know that or not. Oh, you can't find any .22 ammunition in any quantity. Maybe 50 to 100 rounds somewhere here and there, spotty. There is no ammunition, 9mm and .22. The government's buying it and destroying it. And Bull Riders, my big sister, she's been single for a number of years. She's a good-looking lady, nice lady. She ran across one of her high school sweethearts, a Bull Rider, a little bitty fella. And they just renewed acquaintances here a month ago, I guess, over the phone. And he went and spent a few days with her. He's a rodeo contractor around Texas here. He's still riding them, but he ain't riding them, but he's raising them for bucking stock. Ain't that something? 70 years old, and he's still chasing my sister around. it's a good deal, though. He's a fine guy, and I used to run with his younger brothers years ago. We were desperados, so to speak, riding horses out through the wilderness over there. But in 1950, something. Anyway, okay, I just want to make those two quick comments about the bull riding and the bullets. Bye.
All right, my brother. Yeah, I know about the bullets. I got my friend calling me from Oregon all the time, telling me, finds me some 9mm. Tell him, dude, it's just as scarce here as it is there. Yeah, that's just crazy. Yeah, they figure they get the ammo, then you can keep your gun, but you just won't have no ammo. Which is crazy. Just insane. Right, my brother. Yeah, that's cool, man. I hear that story a lot of time. I hear that story a lot of time, folks. 50 years later, 20, 30 years later, the sweetheart comes along and kind of get to start life over again. You know what I mean? That's always a good thing, man, because you don't want to leave this crazy world alone, man. You don't want to leave this crazy world alone. But, all right, my friend. Take care, and I'm out of here, Mr. Burns. I will get back with you. 40-40. Great shake. Let's go.
See you, bud.
Boy, I tell you what, my friend, there's so much traffic out there right now. There's so many of them out there right now trying to come back and get on there. Too many big dogs on the porch. Anyway, if you can still hear me out there, 551. Happy afternoon to you again, my friend.